Muraka tells a story that nobody has ever heard of. Nobody knows what's going on with these people. So that makes it a very distinct and unique game.
The Tarahumara culture is one of the most interesting hold of Mexico because of the fact that they were able to isolate themselves from the rest of the society.
And they're one of the first cavemen, literally, and they're alive even today.
Siguen conservando su cultura, sus vestimentas y tradiciones, por decirlos, porque bailamos matachinas y húmares. En Semana Santa, pues hacemos otras fiestas.
Existen infinidad de mitos. Parte de eso tienen algo de cierto. Uno que ha vivido alrededor de ellos. Se da uno cuenta.
Nosotros así cuidamos el mundo. Sí, pues es que nosotros quedemos a buscar la vida.
The Tarahumara are world renowned for their amazing endurance, and that's portrayed in the game by the means of running. You have unlimited stamina.
If you research the Tarahumara and ultramarathons, you're going to find that they have broken a lot of records while running with sandals.
Yo les hago guarache, pues agarro una llanta y me pongo a hacer, pues les paso el cuchillo así, rajando y así.
No, pues nosotros no entrenamos, pues nomás así nos corremos nosotros, así sin entrenar.
There's a legend that says that the Tarahumara hunted deer by running them down, so literally running with the deer until the deer got tired and then tackling it down.
Pues ya no lo quiero dejar, quiero seguir corriendo. No seguir adelante todavía.
I mean, you expect to find runners in a plain, in a city, or whatever, but not in the mountains.
The game of Mulaka is based on a lot of regions that are really important for the Tarahumara. For example, the Basasiachi Waterfall. There's also the Barrancas del Cobre, which is also called the Copper Canyon. These are a lot of locations that are known globally, but unfortunately, people don't know the connection they have with the Tarahumara.
Even though I didn't know about this mythology, this is still like part of the city I live in and the state and the country I live in. So I really feel proud that we can get to share this amazing culture with the world.
Eche rehoi mapeviste arejena uchimova kano reweamenire wabehi weamenire waber espawiriame to okoyua omere respárrabo muyena peo. Peo kwa te arekite. Mapali oke atinare. Nese na nesimia. Mapali nara te are. Aniwa mape etikano. Peo kona hitare. Ye wa bere pawiriame. Ke sinet machirua me echoko. Enara itareko. Ki yanirua meko.
Myths are very difficult to interpret. They're living things, and they entail different layers of meaning.
Esas leyendas no estaban ilustradas muy bien.
Entonces teníamos que buscar inspiración en lo que son ellos como personas, en sus colores, en sus atuendos, en su forma de vivir.
Muchas criaturas de la mitología tarahumara pues se basan en que todas las cosas de la naturaleza pues están vivas.
El Rosibari, que es la piedra come almas, es una piedrita que está rodeada de un espíritu.
Tú verías una piedra con dientes, pero para un sukurame o esta visión que ve el mundo espiritual, ve una especie de fantasma, de espíritu.
Se creía que los rarámuris poseían tres almas, los hombres tres y las mujeres cuatro. Entonces esto se nos hizo muy padre en cuestión de gameplay porque podríamos poner que esta criatura te succionará las almas y te quitarán pues una vida.
They have this god by the name Ganó. He was probably a vegetation god.
Que comían niños chiquitos que robaban y llevaban la cueva.
Se encuentran las huellas por ahí en el monte.
Decidimos crear varios tipos de ganocos, varios tipos de gigantes. que algunos son hechos de piedra, otros son hechos como de árbol, de un bosque.
The Cero people were huge mantis, and they used to fight the Tarahumara very strongly. They are identified nowadays with the Tepehuani.
Porque son los únicos enemigos que son muy humanoides. Sientes más el combate mano a mano.
Usan sus cuchillas como karate para luchar con Mulaka, entonces están como civilizadas para la hora de caminar y brincar, son muy animalescos.
Since I first began to visit the Tarahumara homeland, it really opened to me like a wonderful new view of what human imagination can contain regarding the world and our place in the world.
Creating Mulaka was a no-brainer. These people have some fantastic legends that really belong 100% to an action game like the one we are creating right now.
There are a lot of cultures that have disappeared from the world, and they are still here. And the more that we research about it, about this culture, the more interesting stuff we found.
According to the Tarahumara mythology, there have been successive destructions of the world.
If humanity is corrupt enough, then they will be wiped out. That's the main plot of Mulaka, to convince the demigods to help you and prove that humanity is worth saving.
The mission of the Tsukurame is, well, to stop the destruction of the world, right?
Tsukurame means sorcerer. I think that originally the Tsukurame were leaders.
It's kind of like the most playable and interesting part of all the mythology that we found. Like, this is it. This has to be the character of the game, the main character.
Nowadays you can Google anything, and with the Tarahumara that's not the case.
When you have the task of representing a whole culture, you have to take a lot of precautions.
So we needed to go and look for authors that already made that research for us in a way.
The people of Lienzo were very open to my suggestions so the myths could be as authentic as possible. So I think that's one of the most attractive things of the whole game. I think it's beautiful because of that. It takes, you know, very old things and it turns it into quite new cultural products.
We worked really hard in making the game a game first, by mechanics, by a good combat system, by a good exploration system.
And then after that, you know about the Tarahumara.
Changes begin to appear. The younger kids become Mexicanized.
Son de aquí gente, pero se fueron a vivir en Chihuahua. Entonces dice ahí en ciudad, en los jóvenes que están creciendo, que ya no saben hablar Tarahumara, están perdiendo todas las culturas.
The governors told us that whatever we can do to keep the Tarahumara culture alive, it's a good thing.
So what the game does is to recognize or to pay homage to another culture. Indigenous Mexican cultures still have a lot of things to offer.
We believe that video games are really the best medium for storytelling. So with Mulaka, what we want is to engage people in the legend, engage people in the stories of this culture.